Hi, I'm Stefanie Perrin, a Board Certified Behavior Analyst at Brett DiNovi Associates, and I'd like to discuss improving behavioral interventions with reinforcer dimensions. So these are some of the task list items from the 5th edition task list that will be covered today. The natural environment consists of concurrently available reinforcers, each on a different schedule, and we allocate our responding between those alternates. Even when program contingencies are in effect, the individual has a choice: respond on the program contingency or some other concurrently available unprogram alternate. These choices are influenced by both response and reinforcer dimensions. Response dimensions consist of things such as response effort, that is, the amount of effort necessary to emit a single response. For reinforcer dimensions include things such as rate, the schedule with which reinforcers are produced, quality, preference level for the reinforcer, magnitude, the amount of reinforcer, or delay, the time between the response emitted and receiving reinforcement. Behavior change programs can likely be made more effective when the dimensions are taken into consideration. Neef, Shade, and Miller in 1994 describe a reinforcer dimension assessment using brief functional analysis methodology as described by Cooper and colleagues in 1990. The assessment measured the effects of reinforcer delay, rate, quality, and response effort on the response allocation of students with emotional and developmental disabilities. Using allocation of time between concurrently available sets of math problems, preference for high or low values of each dimension was assessed. For example, one choice was working for reinforcer delivered now or reinforcers delivered later after a 24-hour delay. Next, across six conditions, each dimension was placed in direct competition with the other dimensions. For example, low-quality reinforcers delivered immediately versus high-quality reinforcers delivered following a 24-hour delay. Results indicated that the most influential dimension for two participants was immediacy of reinforcement, for three participants, the quality of reinforcement, and for one participant, it was the rate of reinforcement. Collectively, the results of this and other studies indicate that the sensitivity of reinforcer dimensions is idiosyncratic, thus must be assessed for each individual. Individuals have preferences for dimensions of reinforcement, and these preferences influence choice, which suggests that behavioral interventions can be improved when the design incorporates reinforcer dimension preferences. Nancy Neef and Megan Noon-Luntz used the brief assessment I described earlier to inform behavior interventions for two children diagnosed with ADHD. The results indicated that for one participant, reinforcer delay was most influential, followed by reinforcer effort, whereas for the second participant, reinforcer quality was most influential, followed by reinforcer effort. In the second phase of this study, the authors used the results of the brief assessment to design a DRL for disruptive behavior during quiet time. A reversal design was used to assess the effects of a DRL that incorporated the most preferred dimensions of reinforcement with a DRL that did not incorporate that reinforcer dimension manipulation. For both participants, the intervention that was based on the results of the brief assessment resulted in lower levels of disruptive behavior than the comparison intervention. Similar findings have been obtained for interventions other than DRL. For instance, in a 2018 study, Romani and colleagues compared the effectiveness of more and less preferred token economy arrangements. All three participants demonstrated lower rates of problem behavior during the more preferred token economy, and one participant demonstrated higher rates of compliance. In addition to improving effectiveness of interventions such as DRL, manipulations of reinforcer dimensions can help reduce reliance on extinction. Extinction is a component of many interventions in the applied setting. For instance, differential reinforcement schedules such as functional communication training arranged on a concurrent schedule between reinforcement for functional communication responses and extinction for problem behavior. However, at times, extinction is not feasible, such as in the case of escape extinction with a large, aggressive individual, or possibly such as when attention-maintained problem behavior necessitates response blocking. Athens and Vollmer demonstrate how manipulating dimensions of reinforcement can reduce reliance on extinction by influencing allocations of responses for the functional communication response. As opposed to implementing extinction, one or more dimensions of reinforcement was manipulated such that it favored appropriate behavior. For example, for a single dimension manipulation, FCR produced reinforcement for 45 seconds, while problem behavior produced only 5 seconds of reinforcement. In a multi-dimension manipulation, FCR produced 30-second duration of reinforcement with no delay, where problem behavior produced only 5 seconds of reinforcement following a 10-second delay. Results indicated that while manipulations of individual dimensions were effective at shifting allocation to appropriate responses, combinations of multiple dimensions were most effective. In a recent example, Davis and colleagues applied these findings to the treatment of escape-maintained problem behavior exhibited by a 7-year-old diagnosed with ADHD, ODD, and disruptive mood dysregulated disorder. By providing differentially higher quality of reinforcement for an FCR than problem behavior was successfully reduced to zero levels and task completion increased. Concurrent schedules of reinforcement are common in applied settings. Therefore, response and reinforcer dimensions are important aspects of any intervention. Assessing preference for dimensions of reinforcement and using these findings when designing interventions can not only lead to more effective behavioral interventions, but also provides a way to reduce reliance on extinction. Please make sure you subscribe to our channel, and I look forward to reading your comments.